Notes on a Vogue Aesthetic. 1. Aesthetic tributaries, sites of diffusion. Locking, tutting, lofting, named for the loft nightclub at 647 Broadway and Bleecker. Funk dance, house, whacking, b-boy, up rock, top rock. 2. Points of adaptation. Kung Fu movies. Aired Saturday afternoons, New York Channel 5, late 1970s, early 1980s. Gymnastics. Hieroglyphics. Ballet. Vogue magazine. From which enough poses were borrowed that the dance form ultimately came to adopt the name runway shows. 3. Related forms of aesthetic battling. Playing the dozens, here reading. Afro-Caribbean drumming traditions. Rumba, bomba, son, mambo, plena, salsa, mangolina. Stepping, the hip-hop cipher. From five percenters, the circle, the ring, spiritual center, energetic focal point. 4. Sites of inception. Collective geographic memory. Rikers Island Prison. Queer inmates stage campy Christmas pageants as holiday entertainment for the remainder of the incarcerated population. The pier. Here introduce pier queens. Union Square. Paradise Garage. The Village. Queer youth who are unwelcome in their own neighborhoods travel to the Lower East Side, where wealthy gay inhabitants frequently call the cops on them. Washington Square Park, the Sound Factory, the Elks Lodge on 139th Street. Black drag queens, tired of losing downtown pageants, return to Harlem and throw their own competitions, which come to be known as balls. Central Park, Sally's, Escuelita. Queer Estes, say their names and name yourself. Tracy Africa, Angie Extravaganza, Crystal LaBeija, Willie Ninja, Jose Extravaganza, Avis Pendavis, Ray Ray Chanel, Venus Extravaganza, Paris Dupree, Prince Milan, Kelly Mizrahi, Tanae Pendavis, Christian Marcel, Shanice Ebony, Luis Extravaganza, Angina, Jante, Javier Ninja, Harmonica Sunbeam, Jamie Extravaganza, Nina Flowers, Carmen Extravaganza, Stephanie Milan, D'Angelo, Derek LaBeija, Lola Balenciaga, Eric Christian Bizarre, Giselle Extravaganza, Deshaun Ibisu, Jose Revlon, Cindy Woods, Bebe Zahara Benet, David Ian Extravaganza, Jack Mizrahi, Whitney Mugler, Pixie Revlon, Pepper LaBeija, Brooke Extravaganza, Octavia St. Laurent, Selvin Mizrahi, Betty Ninja, Cassandra Ebony, Leomi Mizrahi, Princess Extravaganza, Kiki LaRue, Gina Devine, Derek Extravaganza, Aviance Milan, Dorian Corey, Kevin Jordan Zion Prodigy, Pony Zion, Jahida Extravaganza. 6. Common representations. Sissy, hustler, go-go boy, home wrecker, funny faggot, i.e. it is easier to exist as the constant butt of joking than the constant target of violence. Bacla, badin, bajo, bajaro, invertido, buchota, pendejito, joto, maricón, masisi, chichiman, batiguay, punk, pussy, bitch nigga. 7. Radical doctrines. Dance as ethnography. Improvisation as a bulwark against stagnation. Form as embodied history. Physical memory. Aesthetic battling as a metaphoric commitment to struggle. Knowledge as process rather than product. The queer body as a source of revolutionary movement. Street dance as guerrilla art. reliance on the feminine as resistance of the patriarchal, cultural diffusion as the challenging of commodification, physical movement as the epitome of praxis, dancer as insurgent. What I'm going to do now is follow a set of instructions that I give to the best of my ability. I do this not to teach the form or put it on display, but rather to illustrate the mental process that occurs when a dancer is forming a new phrase. Stand in one spot. Train the eyes forward. Square the shoulders. Straighten the spine. Give the dance as an offering. Keep the head and torso stationary. Think of each part of the body as a plane or surface. By touching the surfaces in varied ways, one can generate shapes, playing with symmetry and asymmetry. Lock the elbows. Shoulders back. Allow the wrist to drop with its own natural gravity. Use the hand at the elbow as a fulcrum. Cultivate a keen awareness of the joints down to the knuckles of each finger. Be sure angles are present at every stage of motion. Sharpen your knives. Power can be practiced. Think of the physical phrase as a literal one. Punctuate with snaps of the wrist and decisive ending poses. Forget the difference between dancing and moving. Let music instruct motion. Tell a story with your hands, Javier Ninja. Push memorized combinations until they reveal entire new ways of moving. Imitate and then create. Make something out of nothing. Refine your craft before testing it. B-boys, B-boppers, and all other great improvisational artists receive you. Turn the body into something other than the site of someone else's desire. Always bring the hands back to the shoulders and face. Trace up the left arm with the right index finger. Be fierce. Fierceness is no singular quality or demeanor, but rather is to locate your own unique element, then embody it at all costs. To click, roll the left shoulder gently forward and hold. Think of those who have danced the dance before you. Brush the right cheek with the tips of the fingers. Claim beauty in horror as only we can. Avoid repeating phrases. Breaking cycle is radical. Pull on the right hand by grabbing with the left. Let daily tasks be dancing. and make the dance a daily task. Fight to exist as a whole being. Turn the shoulder and splay the fingers. Know that the dead are always moving with you. I started voguing when I was 16, after watching a clip of a Marlon Rigsman. Essex Hemphill was reading a poem while the camera panned over a corner bathed in streetlight, scene of Queens voguing. The first time I attempted the dance, it came naturally, not because I had any skill as a dancer, but because I was finally allowing my body to move in the ways which it already knew, remembering what I did not know I had forgotten. When I was 16, I was afraid to be seen for what I was. I spent hours practicing in front of the bathroom mirror, after watching a clip of a Marlon Riggs film. I realized my body had been silenced for a long time. The problem of thousands who had carved the same spaces in air with their own hands, suddenly revealing themselves to me. As Exemphil was reading a poem, I did not know I had stopped myself from moving this way. The probable thousands, with their own hands, calling down the halls of my bones, while the camera panned over a group of boys waiting in the locker room to see if they could make me scream like a girl. I had forgotten to wake up the movement. I tried to say some word for what I was, to see if they could make me scream like a girl. How do you cross your legs? I did not know what it was at the time when I was 16, seeing of Queens voguing to see if they could make me scream like a girl. How do you cross your legs like a girl? How do you bend your wrist like a girl? Cross your legs, bend your wrist. While the camera panned over, I was afraid to be seen, kept it a secret, tried to say some word. The probable thousands, rejoicing at the altar that was theirs before I gave it, I had forgotten to see if they could make me scream, calling down the halls of my bones, boys who waited in the locker room. My body had been silenced for a long, long time. Wake up the movement, corner bathed in streetlight. Before I gave it, I kept it a secret. As Exemphil was reading a poem, I tried to say some word for myself. A list of truths. That the dance shakes into waking all dormant things. That possession is not the same as ownership. That shame is learned, not inherent. That the dance was not meant to be performed in this space. That the body may hold more memory than the mind. That the mind, too, is a faction of the flesh. That improvisation is the practice of revolution. That our language is not broken, and neither is our dance. That the critique of old systems is not as powerful as the creation of new ones. That we are each reborn at every moment. That we were powerful before we attempted power. That greed for knowledge is still greed. That fear germinates in a spirit starved of art. That the state is also capable of improvisation. That finding strength in the mundane can sustain us. That a progressive institution is a contradiction in terms. That the body offers wisdom if we are willing to listen. That the production of knowledge, like the production of matter, is impossible. That dance is the wedding of reflection and action. That art is a staple, not a luxury. That the absorption of our identities does not make the system radical. That insurgence gives honor to our ancestors. That art is not an end, but a precursor. That the source of injustice cannot serve as the solution to injustice. That improvisation combats the complacent. That sex is good, but the body is good for more than sex. That the dead cannot sleep within us while we dance. That the word existed before it was written. That loving and struggling are reciprocal processes. That conflict is a step toward comprehension. That compassion, too, is human nature. That the dance can speak what the poem cannot. That resistance and resilience are distinct but inseparable. That rebellion is love for the world reinvigorated. That consumption of the radical does not make one a radical. That trust in the people is the basis of true liberation. That art is born from the necessity of resistance. That the dance will not allow us to move on the world without altering it. That we are meant to dismantle this institution, not placate it. That we are deviant, which is precisely where our power lies. That dance is memory, awoken in battle. Thesis statement. Ultimately, the form takes up a vocabulary of movement commonly associated with weakness and perversion, and fashions from it an aesthetic of power around which identity and community are formed. In so doing, it establishes itself as a tradition, instructing its dancers to derive empowerment from the very sources where they are expected to find weakness and shame. By reworking the vocabulary of the queer body into a source of personal and practiced power, Vogue transforms daily motion into the clandestine cultivation of revolutionary energy. Allowing its dancers to find strength in spaces of weakness and hope in places